Hello, if you were in a situation like this, where you had a task like this, and you may wondered, well, what is a push-down automaton? Why do I need it? Why can't I just solve the task with a good old finite state automaton? Then this might be the right video for you. Let's take a simpler language than this for explanation. Let's take a to the power of n, b to the power of n. That means A and B have to be at the same number of occurrences. I don't really care at the moment how many that are. Well, and let's try to solve it with the finite state automaton. Well, you would need something like this, or you might think so. Well, you want to read any number of A. And then you want to read any number of b, well, and more b's, and let this be the final state. So now you can read all every word from this language. That means where you have three a's, you can read it with that loop, and then you have three b's, and you can read it with one transition here and two transitions here. But this automaton can't count the number of A's and B's, and it means it accepts words as well that are not in the language. For example, with just one A and 1,000 B's or something. It's because the automaton doesn't really know how often it took the loop, and it can't count. So let's try something else. Let's try it with another automaton, where you might say, okay. When I read 1a, then I want to read 1b, and then I will be in a final state. And if I read 2a's, then well, I don't need to name everything of it. I don't need to name every state. Well, but if I read 2a's, then I want to read 2b's, and so on and so on. So now we have an automaton that reads words with the same number of a's and b's, but it's a finite state automaton. That means it has a finite number of states and can only read a's and b's up to a number of states I constructed. So this one can read words from this language up to 2a's, and I could also add more states to read 1,000 a's or something. But I can't do it for any number of n, because this number of n can be infinite, and this automaton will just have a finite number of states. That means if I constructed the automaton and it has any number of states, then I can easily find a word that's in this language and that's not accepted by the automaton, because all I need is to take any word that's longer than this. So this automaton just accepts a part of the language but not the whole language. And that's because we can't construct a finite state automaton that accepts the language. So, but, well, let's take me. But now what we can do is take a push-down automaton. I just erase it. And what the push-down automaton does, it can count the A's. It has something that's called a stack. It looks something like this. It has any symbol on the stack, that's the bottom symbol. And now when I want to read A's, and I want to read words where the amount of A's and B's is the same, then I can just count the A's. For example, let's take one word like this, and I can say, for 1a, I can put any symbol, I add any symbol on the stack. For example, I can take a capital A. But it doesn't really matter. I could take small A's as well, or I could take numbers or anything else. It's just easier to take capital A, so it's so you can easily separate or differentiate the both kind of symbols from each other. And for the A, you may think that for any capital A, you read a small a or something. So it's just, I just took a capital A, so that's easier for you. So I read the first A and put a capital A on the stack. Then I read the second A, and again I put any A on the stack. And my stack is infinite long, so I can just count any number of A's, it doesn't really matter. So when I read this third A and put another A on the stack. And now when I read the B's, I can tell the automaton that for every B it reads, it has to take a symbol from the stack. So I read, I read this B and I erase that A. And then I read this B and erase that A. And finally, I read this B and read that A. And now I see the bottom symbol and I don't have any more input symbols. And now the automaton knows that it read exactly as many A's at B's, just because I put one symbol for each A onto the stack, and for every B I take one symbol away. And now I know that the amount must be the same, because if I had one more A, then I would have an A left on the stack. And if I would have a B more, then I, well, then I would see the bottom symbol, and well, and I can't delete any A's from the stack anymore. So, and one important thing is, if I have anything on the stack like this, the automaton just looks from above. So let me draw it as an eye. So that means the automaton can just see that there's an A on the top of the stack, but it can't see what's below the A, and it can't see how many A's there are. It can just see that the next symbol on the stack is an A. Well, it's something you could imagine it like a tunnel where you put big things in, so that you can just see the thing that you last put in. So it's something similar to that. And the other point is, if we read a symbol from the stack, then it's taken away. And that's why we have the bottom symbol, because one thing is, if you have the bottom symbol, then you know that you read all the other symbols that were before it. Another thing is just, I guess, some reason of implementation, because you can't read things from the empty stack, and it would just broke the system. So you need any stack bottom symbol. It could be something like this, or in some books I saw something like this, or it could be any other symbol that's different from all the other symbols that we put on the stack. So now another point. Let me just take this away. Now the question is, what if we have another language, for example, a to the power of n, b to the power of n, c to the power of n? Well, that is a language that's not accepted by a pushdown automaton. I can show you why. Well, just imagine I have three a's or something. Just imagine I have three from each kind again. So when I read the A's, I may put three A's on the stack. And now to read the same amount of B's, I have to erase one A for each B. So I read 1B, 2B, 3B. And now when I want to read the same amount of C's, there are no the symbols on the stack left that with which I could make that it's the same amount of C's as there have been B's and A's because there are no symbols left. So this is a language that's not accepted by pushdown automaton. Let's take another language. Let's take A to the power of N, B to the power of M, C to the power of M, and D to the power of M. D to the power of N. And now you know that B and C has to be the same amount, and A and D has to be the same number of occurrences. And now let's take an example. You would read, you would read 3 A's, and then you want to read any number of B's. So let's say you read 2 B's. Now you want to have the same number of C's as you had B's before. So for every C, you just read a B from top of the stack. So you read 1 C, another C. And now if you want to read D's, you can read A's from the stack for every D you read. So you read 1D, 2D, 3D. And now this is a language that's accepted by the pushdown automaton. And that's because what you have here is that the C and B depend on each other. And A and D has to be the same amount. And that's called embedded dependencies. And that's what context-free languages are. So the languages that are accepted by pushdown automatons are context-free languages. So, and if you have another language, for example, A to the power of N, B to the power of M, so this should be an N. So this looks more nice. And you have C to the power of N, D to the power of M. And now if you want to read A's, let's say you read 3 A's and put a symbol on the stack for each one of them, and then you read any amount of B's, let's say 2 B's. And now if you want to read C's, you want to have the same amount of C's as A's, you would need to erase A's from the stack, but you can't do this because the pushdown automaton can only access the symbol that's on top of the stack. So it can just read B's and it can't reach any A's. So the automaton can't do that. You have the same amount of C's and A's in this case, because B's and D's depend on each other, and A and C has to be the same amount. And it's called crossing dependencies. And that's what not accepted by a pushdown automaton. And also it's not a context-free languages. But you can have embedded dependencies, and they can be very complex. For example, you can, just imagine you would be a long string like this one, and you have this depends on that, and this depends on that, and this depends on that, and this depends on that, and, something like this. And as long as there are no crossing dependencies, it can be accepted by a pushdown automaton. So you can have very complex embedded dependencies. So I hope this video was helpful, and the pushdown automaton to this language I constructed in another video.